like somebody's been off the reservation.
Hey, Rex, there's a couple of good Indians.
They're dead, all right. Dead drunk.
The way things have been happening around here, the only good Indians are dead ones.
Get him on his pony.
Here. Wake up, here. Wake up.
Here. Look out, Rex!
Well, what do you know? He passed out again.
Keeping them on the reservation is sure a job.
Got any idea where they're getting their whiskey?
No, I wish we knew. It's been the reason for all the outbreaks around here lately.
You know they'll do anything to get it. Where's the dividing line between the territory and the reservation?
That's this gully along here and that cliff.
Hey.
He's out of bounds.
Get these Indians back to their camp. What are you doing off the reservation?
Me, Black Hawk.
Black Hawk? For a chief, you don't take very good care of your people. I just found two of them down the trail drunk.
White man bring trouble to tribe. No Black Hawk.
Look, the great white father in Washington's heard about your trouble. They sent me down here to see if I couldn't straighten it out. I'm Rex Allen, your friend. But you signed a treaty with the government. And you and your tribe are supposed to stay on that side of the boundary. I'm down here to see that you do it.
White man no keep treaty. Give braves whiskey.
I'll find out about that, too. But you stay on that reservation. Do you understand?
Supposed to be here an hour ago, Black Hawk.
Horse fall.
Government agent catch.
Government agent? What's he doing here?
All right, I've been expecting him. It's Rex Allen. The agency sent him out here to see what was causing all the ruckus with the Indians. But don't worry, I think we can handle him. He's a brother of my partner.
Jim Allen's got a brother that works for the government?
Yeah.
Looks like we're going to have a family reunion.
Jim's due here any day now. He's bringing in a wagon train loaded with brand new immigrants from the Middle West.
Wear more rifles.
We got a dozen there.
But you tell Black Hawk...
I know, you'll get more, but this'll have to do for a starter. Remember, Black Hawk, you've been told what to do, so see that things are taken care of.
Black Hawk do. Looks like Jim and that wagon train are in for a little excitement.
Yeah, if Black Hawk do.
Hey,
Yeah, what do you want?
I'd like to see Mr. Anchor.
He ain't here. Be back later on.
Can we wait for him?
Why not? Grab a couple of chairs over there in the corner.
Thanks.
Well, I declare. You know, the more you look at these here blueprints, the better you understand them. Now, I can see where that train goes through a tunnel and under a bridge and through another tunnel and
over
another bridge.
Yeah, well, this happens to be the drawings for the barns, or we're going to keep the workhorses.
Well, you could sure fool me.
Hey, what's the big idea?
Oh, I'm sorry.
What's all the racket here?
I just knocked over a barn.
Mr. Anchor?
Yes.
Rex Allen.
Well, I'm sure glad to meet you.
This is Slim Pickens.
How are you, Slim? Named you, right, didn't they? Come on in, boys, and sit down. So Jim Allen is your brother, huh?
That's right. I'd sure like to see him. Where is he?
He's on his way out here now with a wagon train loaded with immigrants. Should be here any day. You know, Rex, I'm glad to see you. It's about time that Bureau of Affairs woke up and sent somebody out here to police these Indians. Those bloodthirsty devils won't stop at anything.
Especially if they're full of whiskey.
Well, frankly, I'm afraid that my government contract will suffer if we keep on having trouble with them. I hope Jim gets through all right.
I haven't seen him for about 8 years, but if he's anything like he used to be, he'll get through.
As Jim always talks about you, Rex. Done all right for himself since he's been my partner on this construction job.
He's kind of proud of it, too. He wrote and told me about you building this spur line for the government.
Yes, it's going to open up this entire territory for homesteaders. Gotta show you part of the layout on the map. Now, we're building a spur line from this point to this one. Here's the main line of the railroad running along here. It's only 25 miles, but it's through the toughest stretch of country in the West. Now, by us building this spur line, we'll save the railroad over 100 miles around the mountains.
Now, ain't that interesting?
You see where it'll open up a lot of good country for homesteading.
Well, Jim thought it would be a good idea to go back east and tell the folks all about this free land. And maybe some of them would like to work for us. We could use a lot of help out here.
You know, it sure is nice of him to be so obliging. Why, them farmers has had a pretty tough time back there. It ain't rained a shirt tail full in now to 5 years.
Jim was always helping somebody. Well, Mr. Anchor, I can see you're pretty busy, so Slim and I'll be running along.
Well, drop in any time. You're both like one of the family.
Gee, thanks. Where did you say we was a-going, Rex?
Out to meet the wagon train and see Jim.
Further to go. We can make a pretty good time. Pretty soon we'll be in that promised land.
Almost too good to be true. My own 160 acres. After my Missouri farm blew away to nothing. Stock all died of starvation.
Doesn't look as if there'll be a drought or any dust storms in this country.
No, plenty of food for cattle here.
Yeah, lots of room. Room for everybody. And with that new spur line we're building, the land will be more valuable than ever.
I hope so. What's that, Jim?
Crow, Mary.
Or Indians.
Indians? But we haven't had a bit of trouble so far. Besides, we're so close to town. You said we were only a day out.
That's right, Mary. Nothing to worry about. Getting kind of late, though. Time for Chuck. Make a circle! Time for Chuck! Make a circle! Time for Chuck!
Thank you. Coming!
It's beans!
It's beans!
And hardtack!
And hardtack! And hardtack!
Can't be staying. Feel like straying. Just a wandering buckaroo. There's no worry. There's no hurry.
No fences to mend.
No. When your trail has no end and no troubles to share, when you're free as the air, no deciding. Where I'm riding, just a wandering buckaroo.
Pretty good. What are they?
Pork and beans.
Where's the pork?
Right under that bean. See? When do you think we'll hook up with that wagon train?
Well, it ought to be more than a day out now.
That first one was no echo. Hey, that was a buffalo gun.
And that one sounded like a Winchester.
Thank you.
from?
Anchor told me you were coming in, so I came out to meet you. Pretty warm reception, isn't it?
You always had a way of turning up when I was in trouble. Mary, this is my brother Rex.
Hi, Mary.
Hello, Rex.
People owned it and burned up. Seed, plows, tools, everything. Now most of their horses gone.
It's a tough way to start out in a new country.
Yeah, it could have been worse. They could have all been massacred.
I wonder why the Indians left when they did. They had enough braves to scalp all of us. How many guns do you think they had?
Not more than five or six, I reckon.
Where do you think they got them?
I don't know. I better get into Red Creek and see anchor. We gotta do something to help these people. You stay here, will you, Rex, and give them a hand?
I'll see if they get their wagons rolling. Send the cavalry out to escort them into town. I'm going over to the Indian reservation.
Jim! Rex! Come quick! It's Uncle Roger!
Jim!
Well, howdy, Jim!
All right, outside, everybody. I want to talk to my partner alone.
I didn't expect you until tomorrow.
Maybe you didn't expect to see me at all.
What do you mean?
That Indian attack. I suppose you had nothing to do with it.
Indian attack?
Yeah, they jumped us. Burned the wagons and equipment that belonged to a lot of nice people.
You don't think I'd arrange anything as dangerous as that, do you?
You might.
Oh, cool off. Use your head. Sit down. I'll admit it's a bad break for the immigrants. It's going to work out all right for us. With all their wagons and equipment gone, they'll have to work for us at our price. Don't you see the spot it puts them in? Just the spot we want them in.
Yeah, but you didn't have to commit murder to do it.
I tell you, I didn't have anything to do with it. Now let's get down to business. They're here and we're going to use them.
I know that. That's why I brought them out here, but...
No buts about it. We can make three times as much money by using cheap labor as we can by bringing in regular construction crews. And remember, the more money we make, the bigger your cut. You'd like that, wouldn't you?
Don't ask stupid questions.
All right. When they pitch camp here, you're going out and sell them a bill of goods. Your brother was looking for you today. He's a new Indian agent.
I saw him. He's on his way up to the reservation to try and find out about the attack. I hope he doesn't find out anything to tie you in with it.
Looks like they're expecting us. They're breaking out the peace pipe.
You don't look like you're in any mood to smoke.
I'm not. Well, the wagon train attacked a couple hours ago. Do you know anything about it?
Black Hawk no leave reservation.
The Indian leading the attack looked pretty much like you, Black Hawk.
Black Hawk not only tribe. Other tribes over hill. Black Hawk peaceful.
I won't smoke the pipe of peace with a man who has a twisted tongue. If I thought I could prove it was you, I'd have the cavalry on you in 5 minutes.
Call Black Hawk a liar.
Yes.
We let Great Spirit decide in fair fight.
Get him, kid.
Spirit says you lie, Black Hawk. You would have killed me, but I'm leaving you with this warning. If you or any of your tribe leave this reservation, the cavalry, the Long Knives, will be down and hang you.
Squaws, too.
Some good news for you. Gather around.
What's the news?
I just been talking to my partner, John Anker. And he expressed his sympathies at your recent experience on losing everything. I told him you couldn't go on with your homesteading until you had enough to buy some new equipment and buy yourself some food. And Anker wants to do everything he can to help you get back on your feet. Now, he asked me to make you all the following proposition. If you'll go to work for him on the construction gang building the new railroad spur, he'll pay you good wages, and you'll soon have enough money to buy new equipment and get started on your homes.
That's wonderful.
So, why don't we start? That's the spirit, folks. Construction starts just as soon as you finish pitching camp.
All right, John.
Couldn't be better. Look at these figures. We're getting $10,000 a mile for 25 miles of spur line. That makes $250,000.
Now, if we were operating legitimately, we could only figure on about 10% of that as profit. But with that cheap labor out there, it'll be closer to 50%.
Sounds good. But when do we begin to see some of this money?
We'll be getting it right along. The government is shipping the payroll once a month.
The immigrants are a little worried about their money. They're down to their last cent, you know, and their credit isn't very good around here.
I know. I expect the stage in tomorrow with the payroll.
All right, I'll tell them.
Give me a hand.
Okay.
Take good care of this. It's loaded. All right. See you later.
Keep those 9-pound hammers swinging up and down that line.
Keep swinging.
Work, for the night is coming.
Keep swinging.
Work in the morning time.
Let's get that train a track.
Work while the dew is sparkling.
Come on and work
on that railroad line.
Lay that track.
Work when the day grows brighter.
Work in the glowing sun.
Morning sun. Work for the night is coming.
When man's work is done for everyone.
Work for the night is coming.
Coming better work
through the sun of noon.
Blazing high in the sky.
Fill all the hours with labor.
You keep your work and rest will come sure soon.
Give every flying minute something to keep in store.
Work, for the night is coming,
so then you'll work no more. Work, for the night is coming,
under the sunset sky.
Lay that track toward the sunset. On a bed of railroad ties.
Work till the last night fades away. Fade to shine no more. Work for the night is darkening. Then man work no more.
Then man work no more.
No
there it is. Mr. Anker, we've been held up.
What happened?
Well, a couple of men stopped us about 2 miles down the road and took the strong box.
Payroll?
Yeah, every last penny of it.
Hey, notify the sheriff right away.
It's a bad break.
On top of that Indian attack, it couldn't be worse.
Won't be another payroll due for a month.
These people can't wait that long. They'll starve to death.
There's one thing I could do. I've done it before in other construction jobs.
What's that?
Script. Now listen to me, everybody, please. We've just had a bad break. Every penny of the payroll is gone, and frankly, I can't replace it. My money comes from the government and is used to buy supplies. Now, there's only one thing I can do. I've done this before in similar circumstances. Sometimes the payroll was delayed, sometimes it was held up, just like today. Now, what I did in those cases was to issue scrip. Do any of you boys know what I mean by scrip?
I never heard of that word.
Scrip is sort of an IOU from the company to its employees. In other words, I'll give you this scrip, which is redeemable at full face value at any of the stores. You can take this scrip to any store in Red Creek and get food and clothing and supplies for it. Now, boys, that's the best I can do.
Well, how do we know your scrip is any good?
Yeah, how do we know they're going to take it at the store?
May I say something?
I think Mr. Anker's been awful nice to you folks after you come into town with your wagon train and your supplies all gone, no money in your pockets. He's just trying to make the best of a bad situation. I know what script is. It's something that a lot of big construction companies use out here in the West when no money is available. Well, it hurts him just as bad as it does you to lose that payroll. I think we ought to ride along with him.
How about it, folks? You going to string along with us and get back on the job?
If Rex says it's all right, it's all right with me.
That's right, Dad.
Soon as I have the script printed up, we'll have a payday.
Oh, great.
Thanks very much, Rex. Come on, Jim, I want to talk to you.
Well, at least they'll have something to eat.
Hey, maybe somebody will invite us to dinner, and I got a toothpick already made. People in the store.
Heyday, man.
Heyday. Here you are. Now, let's see. Counting what you already owe me, that'll make exactly $29.
Oh, don't bother to add it up. I got a blanket up and looking at you. Boy, that's a beauty, nice and warm.
You want this one?
Yeah, that's the one.
Let me see. Well, let's see. Now, that'll total up to $36.40 exactly.
And it's a pleasure to pay you. I'll take the change from this 50. Boy, how I missed that blanket the other night here. Since the fire, I've been freezing to death. You know, it's been awful nice.
Hey.
Take
now, wait a minute. This ain't money.
No, I know, but it's the same thing as money. See, this is a promise to pay from the John Anker Construction
Company. Sure, I know all about that, but I want American dollars.
What do you mean, it's no good? Hey, Darrell. Mike, come here.
Wait just a minute now. I didn't exactly say it was no good.
Wish I could find something different to cook. I'm getting tired of flapjacks and pinto beans.
Hey, yeah, but do you know we work like dogs?
Wait a minute. Cost a lot to freight this stuff over the mountains into Red Creek, and I can't be giving it away for IOUs.
John Anker stands behind that paper. He's getting money from the government all the time. He'll make it good.
I can't afford to take any chances. But I'll tell you what I will do. I'll cash in your script for you at 25 cents on the dollar.
25%? That doesn't amount to anything at all.
Let's find John Anker!
Let's do it. Let's have a showdown.
Just a minute. Wait a minute. Jim, what's this all about? These people took that script in good faith.
Don't worry. Anker will make it good.
Sure, to the storekeeper. But they'll be losing 75 cents on every dollar they've worked for. Look, I stuck my neck out for you and Anker and told these people to work for you and take that script. Now it isn't any good. How about that, Mr. Storekeeper?
Well, now, he did talk to me about it. But you see, I told him I didn't have enough money to carry him.
And Anker knew this stuff wasn't any good when he gave it to you.
Meaning I knew it, too?
You're his partner, Jim.
Now, just a minute, Rex. If you weren't my brother...
Brother or no brother, I'm not going along with you on a swindle. Jim, I think you've got yourself a crooked partner and you're willing to go along.
Why don't you stick to your Indians and stay out of other people's business before you get your head knocked off?
These people are my friends, and this is my business. Slim, get them out of here.
You heard what the man said.
Just a second. Now, wait a minute, folks. This is my store. Just a minute. I demand you do your fighting someplace else. This is my store.
Sure.
You can't put me out of my
Don't want anybody around to see you get your spanking, huh?
Always was a little bashful that way.
Took you behind the barn and showed you how to fight. Didn't remember very much, did you?
Remember?
Yes!
And old boy Rex hit him again! Oh, my store!
I taught you everything you know, and I'll teach you one thing more. To keep your nose out of my business.
Not when it's dirty business.
And you didn't do a very good gesture, did you? Oh, but I'm beginning to get a general idea of who's stirring them up.
When I was a kid, the sun rose and set on my big brother.
I didn't think you could do any wrong.
Well, maybe it's about time you got rid of some of them kid ideas.
Yeah, maybe it is.
Mom and Dad were awful proud of you, Jim. I don't know. I just don't know.
Nice going, Rick.
I'll pay for any damage. Not in scrip.
Jim.
On your feet, fella.
Come on.
What's this all about?
I'll tell you what it's all about. You've been swindling these people. You probably made a deal with this storekeeper to redeem that scrip at 25 cents on the dollar. Let me tell you something else. If you don't redeem it right away for full face value, I'll see that Washington hears about it and you'll have your contract canceled. Come on, Slim. And don't you people worry about your money.
Come on, Jim. I want to talk to you.
Thanks, Barry.
Hey, was you dead serious about notifying Washington?
Yeah, and that's not all. We're going to get to the bottom of these holdups, too.
Boy, I always wanted to ride on one of them stagecoaches.
That's not the way we're going to do it.
How do you feel, Jim?
Tell you how I feel. I feel like I've had nothing but trouble ever since I started in being your partner.
What do you mean?
You heard me. I want out right here and now.
Now, Jim, you don't want out right here and now. The only way anybody quits around here. Get a doctor. Well, go on. Stick around. I'll see the sheriff.
Sure it was Allen.
Positive.
He's gotten wise to our holdup plan. He hijacks the next payroll, I'm really sunk.
Well, turn us loose and we'll take care of him and his partner.
Uh-huh. I got a better idea. Come on.
Just take a mile of rolling pasture with the herd standing by.
That's a cowboy's dream of heaven.
Then at a great big moon a-shining high up in a prairie sky.
That's a cowboy's dream of heaven. The stars a-twinkling, the breeze a-whispering low. The boys around the campfire sing a song of long ago. For there's an old guitar a-strumming out a western melody. In that cowboy's dream of heaven. While on a distant hill the coyote's crooning out the harmony. In that cowboy's dream of heaven. He may be weary from riding all the day, but when the shadows fall around, you're sure to hear him say,
give me a little bit of rangeland, perhaps a pal or two.
That's a cowboy's dream of heaven. And just as long as I am dreaming, I would like a gal that's true.
That's a
cowboy's dream of heaven.
Buddy, why don't you and the boys go out and see if the sheriff or any banker's men are snooping around?
The sheriff?
Yeah. I want to talk to you, Rex. I have some bad news.
What's all this about the sheriff?
It's not about the sheriff, Rex. It's your brother.
I don't want to hear anything about him. The things I said about him to store still go. I ought to...
Don't talk like that, Rex. He's dead.
Jim.
After the fight, they took him to Anger's office, and he died before the doctor could get there. There was an awful gash in the back of his head. Oh, it's all over town, Rex. There's a reward out for your arrest. They think you killed him during the fight.
Now, wait a minute.
Jim, he was all right when I left him.
Oh, I know it, Rex, but nevertheless, they're still blaming you. The marshal and the posse are out looking for you now. Orders from Washington.
There's something smells awful doggone rotten about all this.
I know, that's what I thought. That's why I wanted to warn you ahead of time.
Suppose I should give myself up.
No, you wouldn't have a chance. Anchor's men would see you hang before you could even talk to the marshal.
She's right, Rex. Maybe we'd better get to the bottom of this ourselves.
And that's not all. Those poor people, the money didn't come through today, and they're accusing Rex of taking it.
I did take it, Mary. And I want you to give it to these people. Must be at least half enough here to pay him what Anchor owes him. Now that I know how he does it, I'm going out and get the other half. I'll find out about my brother, too.
Rex, Sean, you better get out of here.
Where'd he go?
Slim and I'll hide out in the hills for a couple of days. Anchor will hear from us. Don't worry.
Rex, I know you didn't do it.
Thanks.
Off your braves, Black Hawk.
The Yakapoo.
Black Hawk, can you use more guns?
Ah.
I should think you could with a white man coming in here and taking your property away from you, shooting up your game and the railroad coming through. I'll give you enough guns to arm your whole tribe if you'll catch two men for me.
Two men?
Rex Allen and his pal Slim. They're hiding in the hills. Send your best trackers out after them. When you catch them, you'll get your guns.
Best tracker? Black Hawk go.
It's a deal. Well, I'll be in town. Just get word to me.
See you, Pooh.
Doggone it, Rex. Can't I build just a little old fire? These cold beans is upsetting my stomach.
Can't have no fire, Slim. They'd find us in a minute.
Darn it, kid. Don't take it so hard. You wasn't to blame for what happened.
They must have killed Jim when they took him over to Anchor's office. I should have stayed there.
Well, Anchor ain't going to get away with it. We'll cane his plow before he's through. But how are we going to do it?
I don't know, but that wire I sent to Washington ought to get somebody with authority out here pretty quick. If I can talk to him before Anchor shoots us, I think we can get it straightened out.
Hey, Quail, hold these beans. I'm going to have meat for supper.
Quail?
Slim, don't go out there, Slim!
Now you tell me.
Black Hawk, this will bring big trouble to your tribe.
Bring big trouble, white man. Anchor pay guns, you too.
Anchor?
Well, I guess we settled that in a hurry.
Huh?
Hold on, boys. I don't go so good this way.
Telegram came in for you.
Railroad commissioner and payroll coming in on first train over spur line. You were directed to meet train and assist in investigation.
Investigation? Somebody must have tipped him off.
Rex Allen. He threatened to do it and he went through with it. He sent a wire to the commissioner in Washington. We can't stand an investigation.
Hey, boss, Black Hawk just sent word they've got Allen.
You better forget that grudge.
Let's clear out of here.
First, we're going to meet that train and get the payroll, and Black Hawk's going to help us. Come on.
How you doing, Slim?
You know, Rex, 20 years ago when I set out to be a cowboy, I never figured I'd wind up out here like a piece of venison curing in the hot sun. I'm all nervous and jerky.
Here comes Anchor. He'll take care of your nervousness.
Nice work, Black Hawk. You kept your promise.
Where are guns?
I can't bring that many guns up here on pack horses. Everybody would know about it.
But you say, have guns. Whole tribe. Catch two white men.
They're coming in on the first train over the spur line. Be here this afternoon.
Blackhawk, no believe. Spur line, no finish.
The train's coming in as far as it is finished. I tell you, there'll be plenty of guns on it this afternoon.
You lie. If you no lie, you have guns. Here, now. Like you say. Behold you too.
There's another good engine.
I tell Black Hawk the truth, but he wouldn't believe me. Now I'll tell you. There are many guns coming up on the train. If you ride with me, you can have them. Lone Feather, you next in line for chief, huh? Black Hawk was no good. He was not smart like you. White man beat him in fight, remember? I too do not like the white settlers. I will lead you in your fight against them and help you drive them from your land. I will even help you destroy the railroad.
Tokatu!
Get on your ponies and ride with us.
Yayo!
Uh-oh.
No get white man till you give gun.
All right, a deal is a deal. I'll see you later, Allen.
Well, there they go. We'll be right back. Watch him, Rex. He's getting his knife, kid. Watch that blade! Stick it on him. Do something, Rex. Don't stand there. Watch that doggone knife, Rex!
Thanks, Blackhawk.
Blackhawk paid debt. Sure glad he owed you something. It's a good thing you didn't kill him when you had the chance.
Attack it. Get your guns and come on with me.
Here she is, kid.
Thank you.
Go on, tie me up good and tight, and I'll show you how I escaped from old Black Hawk.
Hey! That might catch fire! It is catching a fire! Help, Rex! These kids ain't kidding! Oh!
Keeping you busy?
Oh, gosh, since the immigrants took over the completion of building the spur line, I'm just sort of straw boss around here, taking care of expenses.
Seems peaceful now that Anchor and his gang wiped out and these folks working hand in hand with the Indians to build the West instead of tear it up.
Work, for the night is coming.
Keep swinging.
Work in the morning time.
Don't get the train a track.
Work while the dew is sparkling.
Come on and work
on that railroad line.